Well, hey, everybody. Thanks for stopping back in at the Red Barn. The drivetrain's essentially mounted, so I think it's time to start working on the exhaust system. Why don't we start with the headers and see how we do? Hope you enjoy. Well, let's start with something important. First, you probably notice I'm not wearing a black sweatshirt anymore. I have this nice forest green one. I told myself if I got to 100 subscribers, I'd treat myself to a new sweatshirt. So thank you very much for subscribing. Anyway, let's get back to the serious stuff. It's time to work up a set of headers. And the original plan was, I thought I would see if I could get by with using the factory Ferrari headers. Wouldn't that be nice? But they just don't fit. And you can see here in this picture, there's an interference point on the suspension console where it's just not going to work. So what we did was try to see if we could slice it apart, slice the headers apart, and potentially use them, at least as a first go. So here's what they sort of look like. They have this big stainless steel wrapping around them. And so I lopped that off of one of them. And then, as you can see in these pictures, tried scooting the header bundle up one cylinder to see if I could move it far enough forward to get it to clear everything. And it sort of kind of does, but by the time you move it forward, the angle of the exhaust, you know, it's just not going to work. So I figured not only this wouldn't work, you know, the stock ones wouldn't work, but buying an aftermarket header and trying to cut it apart and reuse the pieces wasn't also not going to work. So what we're going to do is we're going to lop the flanges, lop the exhaust flanges off of the headers here. The flanges will head to the mill to be cleaned up. We'll show you that here in a second. But what I'm going to do is if you couldn't tell, I am what they call a tool whore. I love tools and I will do anything for tools. So what I did was I treated myself to, this is a product from Icengine Works, and it is a header modeling kit. What it is a collection of 1-inch centerline pieces that are either straight or a 2, 3, or 4-inch centerline radius curved piece. And it's like Lego header blocks. You just snap these things together and orient them to the way you need them to be to fit, and you've got, in the case of what we're after, we want to have the same number of pieces for each cylinder, and we end up kind of for free with equal length headers. Yeah. We'll get into that detail as soon as we possibly can. Oh, as soon as we get the exhaust flanges decked and get that first extension on there, then I'll be able to start modeling up some equal length headers. Should be a really good time, and I'm looking forward to it. Okay, so here we are at the secret undisclosed shop with all the big tools. We needed the mill today because, as I mentioned, having lopped the exhaust flange off of the Ferrari header, we now need to deck each of these to the same height. All right, that's one and done. We're gonna come back and do the next one, and this stage will be finished. Oh boy, boxes. And when boxes come to us at the Red Barn, it doesn't matter what time of year it is, it's like Christmas. Look at that. These are, oh my goodness, these are our 4-to-1 collectors for the headers. Look at that. These are from our friends at SPD, Specialty Product Designs, Inc. Out of, where are they? Sacramento-ish, California. And what I ordered was
So I got the 4-into-1 collectors. These are, by the way, as you know, 1 5/8 tube to 2 1/4 inch throat. And then I ordered a transition that's 2 1/4 up to 2.5. Now, I'm not gonna run this long. This is just the way they make it. So I can cut this to length. So the transition, as you can see, is really only this much, but they give you plenty of material so you can adjust however you need to adjust. But anyway, so there's our transitions, there's our collectors. And this, you'd think, well, what happens here? That's not gonna work. This is not a slip fit. And the answer is no, you're right. This is not a slip fit. I'm gonna get this out of the way. I'm very excited, if you couldn't tell. A typical slip fit 4-into-1, these would all be separate tubes. And each of the primaries would slip into this tube, and this would end up having like a bump up, if you will, you know, where this would be able to slip in. And I wanted this to be as super tidy as possible. So what our friends at SPD do when they make these collectors, they send you the cutoffs of the tubes that they use to make these. And so what you end up doing is these get put together like this. I don't even know. And then the star is welded to the inside portion of each of the primaries. And then the merge collector body welds around the outside portion of each of the primaries. And then I don't have to run any, you know, spring tabs or bolt tabs or anything. I just have a nice, tidy, you know, nice, tidy, one single weld seam, no big bump up, you know, weld seam, bump down. It just, call me crazy. I like that. And yeah, it's going to be more work, but when has that ever stopped us, right? Anyhow, SPD, exhaust components. This stuff is just lovely. I mean, look at that. Look at that. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. All 304 stainless. And now that we have these, we are going to need to make little half inch standoffs so that, well, standoffs, little half inch starting tubes so that these, which are the basis of the Icengine Works kit, these will fit into the little standoffs, and then from that point out, we can build with the modeling kit. And so these end up just, you know, sliding into here, little expanding rubber locks them in place. But we do need these, because you can see that these don't fit inside the Ferrari flange. So there'll have to be a little bit of porting done just to tidy that up. But the way we're gonna do this is, I'd really like to get a super square cut right away. And while you can do a pretty good job with a bandsaw, I wanted to just play around and try something else. And so I'm going to try cutting them in the cold saw on this. It just is awkward to do larger diameter tubing without crushing it, etc. So I found in the scrap bin a piece of aluminum round stock that just happens to be, I dressed it a bit on the disc sander just to get it to diameter. But what I'm going to try is I'm going to slide this in here as a support piece, and I'm going to just push it in just past the half inch mark. And then clamp this in the vise in the cold saw and slice off a half inch section and see how that goes. Just check the fit, make sure that's nice and clamped. And yeah, this side does get hold of that, but recognize that as I start cutting through this, the pressure that that plug is helping support on this side of the tube, it's not supporting this side of the tube. So I wouldn't be surprised if it ovalizes that just a teeny bit, but not so much that I couldn't just get it back in a vise and give it a quick squeeze and get it back into shape. So let's see how this works out. And you can see, right, it slipped down. So this piece got a little bit ovalized, which is what I thought, but it's probably not the end of the world. Let's see how we did. But all I want to do is just kind of get a, will this work? Because I got to make 8 of these if that's the case. So dimensionally, it looks pretty good. It's got a, you know, it needs a bit of a squeeze, but I think we'll be okay. And something else that's kind of cool is after the cut is made, now I got really lucky on that one. I got right up against that thing. But you can see it also verifies that the end is still square, right? Because that's a nice square piece of stock. So this is working out really well. So there we go. We've got our half inch. I keep calling them stubbies. Our half inch flange connections that get us from the Ferrari size. Still slightly oval right there, so a bit of porting needed, but this will get us to the Icengine Works starting piece, and then we can model from there. Well, here's the latest example of the best laid plans, as the saying goes. So we've got the prepped exhaust flanges, and you saw earlier, I cut 8 of these extensions, I'll call them, starter extensions, so that the initial mount, if you want to call it that, the initial little plug mount for the Icengine Works kit would fit right down in there and allow us to, you know, have a nice tidy starting point. I thought, you know, wait a second, these are pretty close to 1.5 inches, well, pretty close to the ID needed to just have these things set down in there. So I went to the trouble of buying a carbide end mill, 1.5 inch carbide end mill, and was getting ready to just punch these out a little bit so that this would slide down in there. And I started taking a closer look at these and realized if I just took them apart, this one little back piece, if you want to call it that, this is really the mounting point, if you will, that supports the expandable little top part here that works for securing the first piece of the header modeling kit. And I realized that it's close enough. It's really the rubber that was having trouble fitting down in here. And that didn't fall all the way through because it's the right size. But if I hold this up here and give you a look-see, you'll realize what I realized. It's essentially, it's just, it fits-ish. It fits enough that I can just tack it in place, make sure that it's leveled, and we'll just go ahead and use the plastic connector part of that mount, and we'll be good to go. So, that's a long way around to, I didn't need to make these, I didn't need to buy an end mill, I needed to pay a little more attention going in. So, lesson learned, and we'll just spend a little bit of time and get these things all tacked in place. So on this one, I had played around earlier with a barrel sander, just trimming it out, cleaning it up to see just how ovalized this part was as it tapers, how this goes from mostly round to the oval of the exhaust port. But I had opened this up a little bit with a barrel sander, and it turns out I opened it up enough that this one actually does this turned around. This one actually does fit in there, and it actually falls below the surface. So what I did was just worked out, you know, the depth gauge and the calculation, and cut a little fixture holder that will locate this thing right where I want it. All right, so those are all tacked in place, and I just tacked in three places so it can't rock out of position and alter, you know, the fit of the modeling kit. I just took it over to the disc sander and just kind of gave it a quick dress so there wouldn't be any interference from any of the tacks. So we got this part ready to go.
And while I was welding, my friendly neighborhood UPS man stopped by. The best part of boxes and stuff, stickers. And I want to give a quick shout out to this company, Trick Tools. Their motto is no junk stuff. And I would tell you, in my experience, that's pretty true. They sell pretty much the quality stuff. I got this fixturing table through them. This is a Strong Hands Build Pro table. I've been really happy with it. Over the course of this build, you'll probably see various clamping devices and other things. That's part of a, you know, an optional set of goodies you can get. You know, I bought a kit of fixturing capabilities, and there's all kinds of different options for the different kits you want. But again, Trick Tools, great company, at least so far for me. Anyway, here is another neato bit of kit. This is our dummy collector. All right, so this is what I was mentioning will be fixtured. I'm making a huge mess here. But again, I get very excited when I get new stuff. Sorry, like a kid in a candy store. Get this crap out of the way. So this will be on the engine, and then the collector dummy will be mounted, and you heard me mention earlier, I'll make a bracket off the engine, but this will be mounted wherever, you know, I'll do this while it's in the car, figure out this bracketry. But then when we pull everything out of the car, this will just be sitting on the ground or on the stand, and I can use the modeling kit to get from, you know, point A to point B, knowing that when it goes back in the car, it fits. So this is all, again, very lovely stuff. It's fairly self-explanatory. You know, when you get the, you do it with the plastic first, obviously, but then this just all, you know, it fits together and it shows you exactly, you know, you know exactly where it terminates so that, you know, your parts all line up. And as you model everything out and start replacing the plastic model with the stainless pieces that are being cut and tacked together, you end up with things going right where you want them to go. So the dummy collector, and then I treated myself to these as well. I've never used these. We've always improvised with, you know, hose clamps with slots cut in them. But these, as you can probably see and guess, are tubing clamps. And so as you're putting the pieces together, the tubing, this isn't opened up, I'm just trying to demo it, but you know, you can clamp one side of this to one tube, and this swings and rotates, and so this will accommodate basically any radius curve. Let's say we were welding a curve piece onto here, is while you've got this modeled up, you can just clamp everything together, and it holds them, it holds the tubes nicely aligned. And so we'll see how these work out. I've never used these before. They're not inexpensive, and it's a kit of four. So looking forward to trying to get going on this here in the next little bit. So anyway, there we go. We got our flange ready for the modeling kit. We got our dummy collector ready to go. And now it's on me to get back under the car and figure out exactly where I want all this stuff to end up. So that will be the next episode. Thanks for watching. Any questions or comments, leave them down below. And thanks again for watching. Take care.